just made an offer on a house, and I thought maybe you would want to know about some of the costs and expenses involved in just looking into the house that you just fell in deep like with, and you're pretty interested in it, but we need to uncover the condition of the house and some other things. And that's going to cost you a little bit of cash out of your pocket before you really even decide to move forward with the transaction. And then on the back end, when you're about ready to sign on the dotted line and purchase the house, there are a few expenses as well. So let's talk about them coming up right here. Hey, it's Anita with Keller Williams and Discover Sonoma County Living, and let's talk about step number one in the process of you buying a house. So your offer got accepted, and we want to show that seller that you're serious about your offer. So this is what happens. You'll take 3% of your offer price to a title and escrow company. So if you're buying a $700,000 house, 3 times 7 is 21. So that means you'll take $21,000 to a title and escrow company, and they hold it in trust for approximately 17 days or whatever we wrote into the contract, so that you have this 17-day investigation period to find out if you really, really do want the home. And so your $21,000 sits at the title and escrow company in trust. And you can get that money back if you want to leave this deal, but we've got to make decisions and find out about this house within the day we indicated on our contract, which as a default is 17 days here in California. So that's your earnest money. You might want to have a little bit of money in a house buying bank account so that you're ready to go if you find a house that you love, because we got to have that money in the trust or at the title company within 3 days after your offer is accepted. So, okay, we're in our 17-day inspection period, and you want to find out a few things about this house. So one of the things that is done is a pest inspection. And the other thing that you're going to do is the home inspection. Now, the home inspector might say that the roof needs a little bit of looking at, or the swimming pool looks a little funky. We might have to look into that. Or I don't know, the electrical panels, he's questioning it, and he's advising us to maybe get an electrician out to look at the electrical panel. Okay, don't freak out, all right? This is what happens when you go to purchase a house. You're gonna have 17 days to have inspectors come in and look at the home, and you're going to be paying each of them out of your pocket. Many of them like to be paid right there at the house after they've finished the inspection. They're going to each take you on a tour of the house and show you the home. The pest inspector and the home inspector in particular are going to take you around and show you where they found termites or water damage or a cracked window. And after they leave, or before they leave, they want their check. So typically here in April 2021, they each cost about $400. Now, if you're buying a manufactured home, it's going to be in the 200s most likely. If you're buying a 2,400 square foot house or a 3,000 square foot house, the inspectors are probably going to cost a little bit more. So I kind of round it out to $400. Most of the inspectors in my phone are in 2021, $400. They almost doubled since last year. So that's money you'll never see again, even if you walk away from the deal. So you're paying these guys to do your investigating and to find out what are the damages and what's the actual condition of this product you're about to purchase. And if we have to call a roof inspector or any other kind of inspector, oftentimes they'll charge $150 to show up. And we just have to do it. We have to find out the condition of the house. Once we find out the condition of the house, then we read the reports and we have a thorough discussion about maybe some of the things we might ask back from the seller. That's a whole other video over here in that corner. Make sure you check out my other videos on negotiating. Anyway, these are some of the main expenses on the front end of purchasing a house that you might, that you probably will indulge in. Now, here's where you get lucky. If you're purchasing a house these days in Sonoma County, every county is different. Typically, the buyer carries the burden of the inspection cost. But we're getting lucky these days because a lot of sellers are being coached to do inspections before they put the house on the market. And it's great because they not only do the inspections, but when they find out they have a little dry rot or a little water intrusion under a sink or something like that, they repair it. So you're purchasing a house that's pretty much ready to go. Or maybe they're selling their mother's house or something like that, and they never really lived in it, and they want to put it on the market in pretty good shape, but they're not going to put a new roof on, and they're not going to do maybe some major expenses, but they've repaired quite a bit of it. Either way, you'll have copies of the receipts. You may have copies, the receipts for all the work. You may have copies, you'll get copies of the reports that they did. And if they're less than about 5 or 6 months old, there's really no reason for you to go ahead and double the effort and pay the money out of your pocket to do those reports all over again. You see, all of us realtors here in Sonoma County, we kind of use a lot of the same inspectors because they're reliable. They give us great, easy to read reports and pictures on their reports, and we can use them both for our buyers and our sellers. So you never know when you're the buyer whether we're gonna get the reports up front. It's kind of a 50-50 chance here in Sonoma County. But I just wanted you to know that to have these inspectors come out is gonna cost you a little bit of cash. So get it ready along with your initial deposit. Put some money aside in a bank account as your home buying bank account, because this is the money that we need to use to get through the process of purchasing the house. So we've worked towards the end of the transaction. And so I'm gonna talk about the fees that are involved here at the title company and the escrow company when you're up there and you're about to sign on the bottom line and purchase your home. These are called the closing costs. Now, for the whole time that we've been in escrow and you've been looking at your house, making sure that you really like it and really want it and all this stuff has been going on, the title and escrow company have been working diligently behind the scenes doing a few things, like they search the title of the house to make sure there's not a former owner on the house, or that former owner doesn't owe somebody some big chunk of money. They call these clouds on the title, and you don't want to inherit those things, so they clear them up and make sure that they don't get transferred to you. The lender has also been working for you, and they have fees. They have lender fees and transaction fees as well. All these together are called the closing costs. Now, how do you pay those closing costs? Well, one day at the end of your transaction, the title company calls you and they arrange for you to go sign your documents. On the day you go sign your documents, you're also bringing your down payment and all the rest of the money with you that it'll take to purchase this home, all right? And they include, when they tell you the total of what you need to bring, they've also tacked on the closing costs. So it's incorporated in the last chunk of money that you bring to the title company. Now, you can bring a cashier's check, or a lot of times, most of the time these days, people transfer the money from their bank to the seller's bank, which happens through the title and escrow company because they are the middlemen in this transaction, all right? So your title and escrow officer tells you how to transfer the money in a very specific way to protect you from wire fraud. All right, so you know going in when you show up there exactly how much money you're either bringing to the table or you're transferring from bank to bank. ACH transfer is usually what's done, but not necessarily. You might want to bring a check. All right, so they clear that all up with you, and before I run up to the office and meet you, I've had a printout. I got a printout from them showing me all the costs and fees associated with the transaction. And I review it and make sure that you're not charged for something that wasn't a part of the transaction. You also get a copy of that. But as things would go, usually the first time you see it is when you sit down with your escrow officer. Sometimes I get it to you a day in advance, but sometimes just an hour or two before you run up there. Either way, the title and escrow company sits down with you and they review all of the fees involved, all right? So that you know exactly what you paid for. On this piece of paper, it shows in one column what the seller paid for and in one column what the buyer pays for, all right? In this way, I'm talking about transfer taxes and HOA fees and things like that, all right? So it's all the fees involved, not just the fees that are paying the title and escrow company. So you get a nice little printout of everything you're paying for and everything that went on money-wise in the transaction. It's great. Now, sometimes in our negotiating process back 17 days ago, we negotiated to have the seller pay, I don't know, I'll make it up, $5,000 as a credit to your closing costs. And that'll be on your side of the paper. So you get a big old credit. So instead of $9,000 of closing costs, you only paid $4,000. This is a really common practice and happens all the time because, frankly, as your realtor, I don't really want to ask the seller to pay for the broken window and the termite damage. I'd rather they give us cash and that we repair it or you repair it yourself so that you're in charge of who's working on your new house. But sometimes the seller does the repairs. Either way, oftentimes they give you a credit towards your closing, which is really cool. So all this stuff washes out and plays out at the end of your transaction, and you get a clearly printed out document that shows you every single cost and fee involved. So I thought I'd do a little bit of an insert here into the video so that I could define the difference between the down payment and the earnest money. So you might know this, but you have to have skin in the game, right? You're gonna pay a little bit for this house too. So you're getting a loan from the bank and you're having your own chunk of money that you're putting down on the house. That's your down payment, which basically you come up with the biggest chunk of your down payment at the end of the transaction in approximately 30 days. But you'll take 3% of the offer price, which becomes a part of your down payment, to the title company, okay? So you're not doing a down payment or a deposit on a house. You're doing your earnest money, your initial deposit. We'll come up with the rest of the down payment in 30 days when you're just about to wrap it up and buy the house. So what do you think? Did you know about any of those fees or were they a big surprise? Let me know in the comments below. And while you're down there, check out all my free stuff. I have a free buyer's guide and a free relocation guide if you're relocating to Sonoma County and all kinds of other free stuff. I'm also an affiliate with Homes for Heroes. So if you're a local hero, a school teacher, a doctor, sheriff, firefighter, or active or retired military, I give you a nice chunky check after your transaction's over with as a thank you for being a local hero. So check out the Homes for Heroes program. Make sure you give me a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button and the little bell, and you'll get all my future videos and check out the next video coming up in the upper left-hand corner. This is Anita with Keller Williams Real Estate and Discover Sonoma County Living, and I'll see you around the neighborhood.